Hi guys, I'm Lakutus, and welcome back to the Collective. Starting a new series here. This is one I've been looking forward to for a while.
So much backup.
Don't worry, Otana, we've got you covered.
Off ion battery control. Fire!
Green 2, bracket, high low now. He's making his run.
I'm on him.
Can't get a lock.
Thanks, Green Leader.
That was way too close for comfort. Thanks for your help.
No problem, Otana.
Oh yeah! X-Wing Alliance.
Uh-oh. Doesn't look like we got away so clean after all, Galen. We're losing coolant pressure in the primary tank.
You want me to see what I can do?
I think we're fine for the moment. But we'd better stop at our service platform in the Rokas system for repairs.
Isn't Uncle Anton gonna be there? He's gonna
I'll
say
shut up
I told
most of this
you
and,
not to get involved
don't talk
with the
over us the intro.
Yeah, well, I'd rather put up with that than risk trying to get all the way home with this damage.
It's your call.
Hailing Twin Sun Service Platform, this is Captain Tomas Azamin of the Corellian Transport Otana requesting emergency repairs.
Tomas, what happened? Looks like you've been in a fight. You didn't actually contact the rebels, did you?
Everything was just fine until an Imperial fleet showed up. How quickly do you think you could patch up my primary tank?
I'd have to bump a bunch of ships that have been waiting. It's going to cost us if we do that. You're not in any particular hurry, are you?
Well, yes.
Let me guess. You're being followed, aren't you?
Blast your idealism! I told you this would happen! As if the Imperial authorities aren't already difficult enough!
Now, Anton, I took precautions, and I know we weren't ID'd. Look, the sooner we get out of here, the better for all of us, right?
No way! That's Panther's view and you know it!
You can make it home just fine the way you are. You must leave immediately before I report you myself!
Why, you... Are you refusing to help me out?
You're damn straight. I told you we can't afford to get mixed up in this rebellion. We've worked too hard and have too much to lose. Maybe this will make you understand. We'll talk about this after you get home. Twins on platform, out.
Bless you, John Williams. Oh, the music. The everything. The Star Wars-ness. Ah!
Thank you. myself. It is in the best shape I've ever seen it. I cannot wait to take it out on a combat mission. Greetings, Ace. Come on board. I have much to tell you.
Great news. Looks like your dad is going to give us a shot at flying for real after all. Aaron is going to test us out, so we must not blow our big chance. Ace, I've got our instructions right here. Click on my holo projector to see them.
Okay, so before we do that, for those of you who are new, welcome to the collective. Resistance is futile, etc., etc. Yes, I know. Channel Star Trek and stuff, but wait, Star Wars? Surely that's like heresy. Nope, I don't hold with any of that. Star Wars versus Star Trek nonsense. I love them both. They're both fantastic. And at the moment, our Christmas and birthdays, everything have come all at once for Star Wars fans. We've got Star Wars Battlefront coming out in about a week, which, having played a bit of the beta, it was absolutely amazing. Everything I hoped for in a Star Wars game. And, of course, we have The Force Awakens, Star Wars Episode 7, coming out in December, less than a month away now. Just a teensy bit excited about that, but... So yeah, X-Wing Alliance. This is a series that quite some time. I've tried doing this a while back, actually, and if nothing worked right, the game crashed left, right, and center. It just wouldn't play ball. I had all sorts of patches installed, but it wouldn't run. And eventually I gave up on it. I got it to run, but I never got it to run with recordings. So apparently, though, there has been, for some time, a Steam version of X-Wing Alliance, which gets on a whole lot better with modern operating systems. There is also one, I should say, for the sake of comparativeness, one available on GOG, which some people think is a better copy and hasn't got any DRM or anything, etc., etc. But honestly, all I know for certain, I don't have that copy, is the Steam version works on Windows 8, Windows 10, Windows 7, without having to faff around with all sorts of settings. And as of the last update, most importantly, it's compatible with the XWA upgrade patch. Now, for those of you who don't know what the XWA upgrade patch is, which I'm guessing is a lot of you, for those of you who have played X-Wing Alliance, you'll notice when I play the game that all my ships and everything look a whole lot shinier than they did in the original, than when you if you remember playing the game back in the day. That's because the XWA patch basically is a texture overhaul and lighting overhaul, and essentially it just redoes the entire graphics engine pretty much for models for pretty much every ship in the game. And it's like night and day. Everything looks vastly, vastly better. If you do play X-Wing Alliance, if you haven't played X-Wing Alliance and you like space combat games or Star Wars in general, I hugely recommend you to play X-Wing Alliance. Like I said, you can get it through Steam or GOG for about £6, which is about $10, I think, if you translate that into American monies, or about €12, I don't know, £6, whatever that is in your local currency, give or take. If you do play it, and as I said, I hugely recommend you do, have a look for the XWA upgrade patch. It has a sort of the latest version has a sort of standalone installer. You just run it and it will find the game and it will do everything for you. You don't need to tell it anything other than what version of X-Wing Alliance you've installed, Steam, GOG, or the original disc version, and it will patch everything for you and look pretty and shiny. It even fixes a few other niggling issues. Like if you don't have the patch installed, this wouldn't be filling my monitor entirely. It would be cutting off the edges in a sort of it's not a true widescreen patch. There is a separate one you can install to put it to resolutions higher than the game supports. But the fonts tend to go screwy, and it doesn't run quite as well. I actually recommend against that widescreen patch, personally. That's just my preference. Some people swear by it. But, so yeah, X-Wing Alliance, for those of you who don't know what the game actually is a space combat simulator. It's the last game they made in the X-Wing series of games, after X-Wing, TIE Fighter, and X-Wing vs. TIE Fighter. And for my money, it's the best of the series. And not only that, it's the best Star Wars game that has ever been made.